Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to create a final year project report. So let's get started. So before getting the video, I need to just tell a disclaimer. So this is a report that I have made based upon my college rules and norms. So this can vary from university to university and college from college. So please take the guide and help from your professors or teachers and do this. This is not like the best example. I will be just explaining you this as a demo, or you can just a sample. You can take it as a sample and do what you want. And this is not the best or the final version of an university report. So yeah, so now let's jump into it. So I currently am having my report in a Word document. So this is the first page. So as usual, you need to like mention your project name. I am doing this virtual mouse. And here you need to have submitted by, and you will be having your team name. And in this space, you will be having your degree name, that is Bachelor of Technology or Bachelor of Engineering. And here you will be having the course name and the college name. So this is the first page basically. And you will be having the month and the year. And in the second page, it's going to be our college name and bona fide certificate. And here you will be having this bona fide certificate thing. So you need to like mention this. So I, the student name, we are performing this particular final year project review and viva on so and so date, and I think the external examiner on the internal examiner will sign over here. I think this will be provided by your university or college, so you don't need to worry about that. And next comes the acknowledgement. So this is also, you need to type it on your own or the university will provide you. So this basically will have, I would like to thank my parents, my teachers, my friends for helping me to do this particular final year project, blah blah blah. You can like fill it out. And next is going to be the abstract. I have done an entire video on how to do an abstract. You can just check it out, or let me just explain how this works. So the first, you need to explain about the existing technology that your project is based upon, and then you need to define how your project is going to improve the existing technology. And in the later paragraph, you need to explain about how you are going to implement your project. So it's broken down into three paragraphs. That is basically the abstract. You can check my video if you want. So after the abstract, we will be having the table of contents. So it is also called as an index. Basically, you can name it as index. So you need to like please align the page number. Mine is like not aligned properly because I have like converted it from a PDF to a Word document. So align it properly. So we will be having like the chapter number or a particular like subtopics. A chapter consists of many subtopics. Here you can see 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. So this is the main topic. So you'll be having like this. So it's good to have around like how many I'm having over here. Yeah, I'm having 8 subtopics or main topics over here. And each main topic is going to have many number of subtopics. So I would just say the topic's name. You can just follow this maybe if you want, if you like prefer this order. So first one is the introduction. You basically give some detail about your overview, study, objectives of your project. That comes in the introduction. I will also like show the pages as well. Now let me just explain you the index. So after this, we'll be giving the review of the literature, which basically has the literature surveys. So that I'm just having the name of the literature survey that I have referred. That's the second chapter. And the next topic is going to be, that is my design. I think that will have an image, and this will basically explain you the what are the functionalities that I've used in your project. So basically the technical definition of your project. And it's always good to have a summary at the end of each chapter, like the last subtopic of each topic. And next is going to be the implementation. I think we will be using the code. It's maybe having like pseudo code or code snippets if you're doing anything programming related stuff. If you're doing anything related to electronical or mechanical, you can just like draw the circuit and explain the motor processing, those stuff. So this is the fourth chapter. And fifth one is going to be the result and observation. So you want to like maybe you can specify your metrics, graphs based upon your project, and as well as you can also show your project output, like screenshots of your project in case of it is anything related to IT or CSE. That is the fifth main topic. And the sixth one is going to be the tools and technologies used. So since I am doing this project using OpenCV Python, I have just given a definition about each line about the libraries that I have used over here. So this is, you can do this based upon your department or your course. And the seventh one is going to be the conclusion and future works. So this is also a really, really important topic or a paragraph or a part, because even though some person is not going to read this, that person will surely read your future works, because it's like the part where you define how you are going to improve your project in future and what enhancements can be made as well. So I would like you to really focus on the conclusion and future goals, because these are like just from the net, these technologies used, and this is just from the code, pseudo code. So these stuff, people go through it, but they don't mind like reading it high in deep level. And this is like the area we need to really focus on, especially conclusion as well as the introduction as usual. So now let me just, these are the images, actually list of figures. So under each diagram or image, I'll be having this number 1.1. So this directly corresponds to this one over here. That is the page number. Okay, you can like have it. I think it's optional in case they, if you ask to, this is the page number, actually the alignment has been missed. So yeah, let me just now scroll through this. Yeah, it's always good to have images within paragraphs, and always like have bold for your text, like main headings of a paragraph, and have bullet points. It looks good. And you need to also have this. Yeah, I forgot to tell about this. I think in many colleges they will have specified you like the margin. You here you can see, right, it is like centered, it has some space top down and the side margins. So you need to like do that according to your college. Please refer that at first, because if you take a printout, it's going to be hectic, like taking the adding the margin and taking it around. So please refer that. And as well, here you can see I am having this Roman numbers over here for the index. And after the index is over, and once we are going into the contents, I'll be having the number 1, 2, 3. So this is also you need to take note of how your college is going to approach for this number. Some colleges, they will approach directly from numbers from the first page. So take a note of it. But I think your report must have a number, because without number, there isn't any purpose of your index, right? Someone is reading your index, they definitely should have a number. So it's must to have a number to look more professional on your report. It adds good value. So these are some of the things. Yeah, and this is introduction. Just have images, all right? Don't bombard too many images, just have images as long as it is required. So yeah, and have cool images, basically like colorful ones. And yeah, so this is like the objective, and you can make this flow chart diagrams. It adds more value to your project as well. And start a chapter always on a new page. Yeah, that's a good thing. Yeah, have it in the new page always. And yeah, so this is the literature survey, I guess. Yeah, the yeah, so here you can see I'm having the like the topic of the literature survey. I'm having the existing method of that survey and outcomes with the limitation. So it's going to be the what they have conveyed in the literature survey and the outcomes they have mentioned. So this is going to be followed for all the literature survey that you have mentioned. I think I have mentioned like about 6 to 7 literature surveys over here. So yeah, so this is good. And in our college we had a condition to like create and report for about 50 pages. So we need to like extend all the topics that we are going to have. So if you are not having like 50 pages, some constraint, minimum constraint of pages, you can like shrink your content based upon your need. And yeah, literature surveys, I actually like made so many literature surveys to like have more pages. Next one is going to be the third chapter, which is virtual mouse, the system design, like they explained. So I actually created this flowchart using PowerPoint. So you won't remember, PowerPoint is a really good tool to create flowchart. So never underestimate PowerPoint. Yeah, and create these diagrams on your own. Don't copy it from the internet. Yeah, because in some cases they may cross question you based upon the diagram. So if you took a diagram from the internet, that may have some irrelevant text over there, and they would ask what and why you are doing this. They would easily figure it out that you have took that image from the internet. So please create your own flowchart and diagrams. So this is just the input data set that I'm using over here. Yeah, you can pause and like read it out if you are doing this exact same topic. So this is some of the ways or the procedures that I'm going to use in my project to detect my hand. So I didn't tell you this, right? So my project is basically about if I like controlling the movement of our mouse with the help of hand gestures. So I'll be getting the input through the camera. So through my hand gesture, I will be able to like select the files and folders, drag and drop the folders, close, open, like do multiple stuff. I think I actually like did some hand gesture to even take the screenshot of the screen. I will be showing you that. Yeah, so this is the next thing. This is like the procedures of how doing it. And the fourth one is going to be the implementation. So here I have like added the pseudo code and the code over here. I have just explained like the step by step chunks of code, and I have like explained it. So it depends really if you are going to use pseudocode or the code. If you are using the code, it's easy. You can just copy and like paste it. But if you are going to use pseudocode, you need to like really work on the typing part. Yeah. So I will just scroll real quick. Yeah. So this is basically just Python. Python actually looks like pseudocode. So I converted Python into a pseudocode. That's the funny thing over here. Yeah, I've also done hand gestures to even close the application. Yeah, and this is the result and observation. So kindly have it in a separate page. Mine is misaligned. Yeah. So these are some of the screenshots they have added, and I have also like explained. So this is how it looks. I can even the finger counter basically good for this one. Yeah, this is the metrics that I told you. Some graphs, features, and observations. You can just try doing that. And this is the technology used. As I told you, I've used computer vision, deep learning. This is just from copy from net. You can just paste the definitions of this. You can't like recreate on your own. MediaPipe. This is a library that I used. If you want, you can study more about it. It's such a cool thing. It's a cool project, you know, like Tkinter, OS model. Everything is related to Python. It's a 100% Python project. And chapter 7 is going to be the conclusion. So make sure you do it well, this conclusion. And also give enough space between paragraphs. Don't mess it up too much. And also, this is the main thing. You need to have this alignment, right? Everything aligned to center. So here you can see, right? The end of everything is like center aligned. So this is like coming out. I don't know why. But apart from that line, everything is like aligned neatly, right? It's centered. There isn't any extra space. So make sure that, I think if you click some buttons over here in this, four buttons that will work. So try doing that. Select the paragraph, press some buttons, it will happen. Yeah, and future works, keep it short and sweet. That's the thing. And summary, and at the end, you need to like have some references related to the images that you have used, as well as the literature surveys that you have used. So really simple. I have like 68 pages. That's such a large number. And just have enough spaces and don't make it shabby. Have margins and use bullets, use bold text, and just follow the index that I've told you. I think my report is kind of a good approach, you know, like if anyone is reading, it creates a good feel to read because it has everything that's what's needed basically about your project. A person who's going to come externally will know everything by reading this report. So I hope you would have found this video useful. You can also comment down your reviews about my report and what could be improved as well, so that others also are getting benefited from that. And mine is a programming channel, by the way. I have done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.